Hello, friends. So we're here again with some news which you may find interesting. Our research folks have gathered three updates for you today. Let's start with SpaceX. After some time, SpaceX's SN6 hop test, the company shared some details about its next prototype of their Starship's lineup. CEO Elon Musk said that the company's new Starship prototype SN8 is currently being developed at their Boca Chica facility in Texas. A few weeks ago, the company completed a hop test for its SN6 Starship prototype. According to Musk, their new Starship prototype model is targeted to be done in its final production in about a week. He more added, this time it will have flaps and nose cone, and ultimately aims to reach a much higher altitude during the test. Up until now, SpaceX has successfully performed two of its Starship prototype test flights, though both were short tests. Those prototypes that took a successful takeoff from the ground and landed after reaching a height of 150 meters had simulated weight installed rather than an actual dome nose cone on the top of the Starship. SpaceX's previous prototypes, SN5 and SN6, which were kind of look like grain silos, didn't have the flaps on both sides and nose cone, thus ended up lacking control during its test flight. However, SN8 will have both, Musk said. As per SpaceX, the Starship prototype SN8 would not be missing any of the basic tests, including static fire tests and other ground checkouts, before attempting the hop test. After completing all the tests, the Starship is targeted to achieve an ultimate milestone of flying an altitude of 60,000 feet and returning to the ground, followed by a controlled landing. The CEO of SpaceX, Elon Musk, is optimistic with the new Starship prototype, as the company is going for a big leap this time. Developing a rocket is quite a difficult task. We could see a number of launch failures on hot fire abort during a test in the history of rocket launches. SpaceX's big leap of taking a Starship from a height of 500 feet to 60,000 feet is a challenging task, as it might end up poorly. The company mainly focuses on rapid iteration and learning from its previous mistakes while making development on Starship prototypes. SpaceX keeps track of data from previous failures and adds them to its successor. In addition, it may not have made Musk's crazy timelines, but the company is accelerating its work, especially now that the most recent prototypes have shown success in their tests, reaching up to its mark. Now, let's discuss about Astra, a new horse in the race of space market. The first orbital mission of the startup company Astra did not go well, as their rocket 3.1 took a successful liftoff but later came back to the ground again. Astra is an aerospace startup company located in Alameda, California. The startup company launched its first orbital test flight, a two-staged rocket 3.1 skyward, from the Pacific Spaceport complex in Alaska. The launch was initially scheduled at 11:19 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. The 38-foot-tall, 12-meter rocket vehicle, which was not carrying any payload, took a good start, but rather than going to orbit, it faced a premature end. A spectator caught a video footage where we can see the rocket flies off the ground, leaving a white tail of smoke, but a few minutes later came down and hit the ground with a fiery explosion. Successful liftoff and flyout, but the flight ended during the first stage burn. It does look like we got a good amount of nominal flight time. More updates to come, Astra tweeted later in the incident. Updates arrived quickly after the crash. The company gave a possible reason that caused their rocket to crash. Preliminary data review indicates the rocket performed very well. Early in the flight, our guidance system appears to have introduced some slight oscillation into the flight, causing the vehicle to drift from its planned trajectory, leading to a commanded shutdown of the engines by the flight safety system, Astra wrote in their blog. This is not the first time that the startup company has faced launch failure. Astra launched only a few rockets in the past 2 years. The first two suborbital test flights, named Rocket 1.0 and Rocket 2.0, launched in 2018, which were believed to be launch failures. However, the company stated that both were successful. For this one, they said itself that it was not expecting a perfect launch. In their pre-launch mission description, officials wrote that their goal with this rocket, to achieve a nominal first-stage burn, which would keep the company on track to reach orbit with their upcoming flights. things did not go according to the plan, though Astra has sufficient amount of data collected from the rocket failure. Astra will analyze those data and use them on their next attempt. The company still aims to reach the orbit in 3 tries or fewer. Astra is currently working with a very small crew that they don't even have a video production team to broadcast its launches live. The company said only 6 members of their team developed this launch system in less than a week. "We didn't meet all of our objectives, but we did gain valuable experience, plus even more valuable flight data," company representatives wrote in a blog post. "This launch sets us well on our way to reaching orbit within 2 additional flights, so we're happy with the result." As a startup company, Astra offers dedicated rides to space for small satellite in a more budget-friendly cost. The company's website shows payload weight requirement that's between 110 pounds and 330 pounds, or 50 to 150 kilograms, for delivery services up to 310 miles high, or 500 kilometers into orbit. Another California-based startup, Rocket Lab, has quite a name going on this moment, on this side of the growing small launch market. To compete with Rocket Lab and crave a name for itself, Astra offers a cheaper alternative. "What we're trying to do is build a service that has a lower cost to operate and a lower cost to provide the launch service," Astra's CEO Chris Kemp said in a conference held on July 30th. "That involves a much cheaper rocket, a highly automated factory, a highly automated launch operation, and really just a real focus on efficiency and removing costs from every aspect of the service, so that we can achieve scale and ultimately drive costs down through economies of scale and production." Astra initially planned to launch its Rocket 3.0 in March 2020 as their first orbital mission. However, weather didn't cooperate on that, and apart from that, some technical issues also found in Rocket 3.0, which canceled the launch on that day. The company had this launch for an amount of $12 million as DARPA, the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, launch challenge. Later, in the end of March, Astra's Rocket 3.0 found damaged while preparing another launch attempt. This launch was not under the DARPA launch challenge. Therefore, the orbital liftoff milestone was past successor Rocket 3.1. Poor weather and some minor issues pushed Rocket 3.1's launch schedule back several times until September 12th, which was the third launch for Astra. Now, let's look into some more news from China. China recently launched a new high-resolution remote sensing satellite for the Jilin-1 satellite constellation on Saturday, September 12th. However, the launch of Kaiju-1A solid rocket, which was carrying the satellite, met an unsuccessful end. The launch of Kaiju-1A rocket was initially scheduled to launch from a transporter erector launcher in Jiquan in the Gobi Desert at 1:02 a.m. Later, an amateur footage of the rocket launch came out on a Chinese social media platform. According to the report, the Chinese rocket took a successful liftoff and within an hour reached the low Earth and Sun synchronous orbits. However, disappointing news came out 5 hours later as the state media officially confirmed the failure of the Chinese rocket. The cause of the failure is still unknown. Officials decided to investigate the terse report that stated the specific reasons for the launch anomaly. The rocket was carrying the payload of Jilin-1 Gaofen O2C Optical Earth Observation Satellite. Jilin-1 Gaofen was an observation satellite with a resolution of 0.76 meters and a swath width of 40 kilometers. China listed its fourth launch failure among 26 launches in 2020, including this Saturday's Kaiju-1A launch. However, China plans 2 upcoming Kaiju-1A launches in September 17th and 22nd. Airspace closure notices were issued for these launches. In 2020, 3 launches from the U.S. and 1 orbital launch from Iran also ended in failure. A Chinese space rocket company, X-Pace, operates the Kaiju-1A rocket, though the China Aerospace Industry and Industry Corp, CASIC, a giant state-owned enterprise, missile maker and defense contractor, initially owned this rocket. It's found that the Kaiju-1A, which was derived from a missile technology, consists of 3 solid stages, with a liquid propellant upper stage. The Chinese rocket could ferry 200-kilogram payload into a 700-kilometer sun-synchronous orbit. Shangong Satellite Technology, CGST, which is a private commercial satellite company, developed Jilip-1 Earth observation satellites, the payload of the rocket. Saturday's Kaiju-1A launch was the first failure of its 10 flights, however, beating its time of failure, Astra's Rocket 3.1 came first in the list. That's all from our side, my friends. We'll soon be back with more updates, so be with us to catch the latest updates. Till then, stay safe, take care, and goodbye. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.